that people upload their products to the website, and I or one of my colleagues, all we do is make sure there's nothing pornographic. If there's nothing pornographic, we post it. We do not pass any sort of judgment on your artistic abilities or your scientific abilities. We love them all and we share them all. And as a result, we've got some really fun things. Okay, tearing ourselves away from the great red spot, and that was tough. We come to the south tropical zone, and we're now down at about minus 31 degrees south latitude. And I'm gonna show you a close-up of this area. This one was actually quite a surprise. We've seen these high clouds before, but we've never seen them absolutely covering everything. So I call these pop-up clouds. They're not thunderheads. There's no lightning. We have a different instrument on the spacecraft that can detect lightning, and it's not there. So these are not thunderclouds, but there's something about Jupiter's atmosphere that is just causing all these little storms to come jumping up. And they're not so little. I mean, it is Jupiter. They're 25 to 50 kilometers high, and that's about their size as well. So something about Jupiter is just causing all these little storms just to pop, pop, pop like popcorn. Okay, I mentioned earlier the string of pearls, and here are two of the white ovals in that string of pearls. One's there, a beautiful brown barge right here, and you can see the kind of detail that we're getting now across a wide expanse of Jupiter's clouds. Okay, this is the South Temperate Belt, and it's called the Ghost. And we actually got four shots of this one, so we were able to put together a little time-lapse sequence on this one. And so now we're looking at the dynamics and how the clouds are circulating in this particular region of Jupiter's atmosphere. Again, all of the annotation, all of the work being done on this being done by amateurs, by citizen scientists. So here we are, we've worked our way now to the southern hemisphere, and here's the string of pearls, the white ovals, and finally we arrive at the South Pole. And this is our typical view. Half of it is not lit because it's nighttime. And but we don't see the pole in the north, the actual pole, because it's in polar night. But the South Pole is polar summer, so it's completely illuminated. And what we've found is that there are five of these circumpolar cyclones around the South Pole. And when you take the data from different Parajove passes, you can mosaic it together. And so this is what it looks like when you do that. So now we can look at the entire South Pole of Jupiter. And again, we're looking at an atmosphere, we're looking at clouds. We see that the latitudinal belts and zones have broken down as we've gotten close to the pole. We see these circumpolar cyclones. There's actually also a cyclone right in the middle of those five, except it's not on the pole. So that's a puzzle. And so we're waiting to see, with every pass, we're like kids, waiting to see what these cyclones have done next. And whether or not that we think there's another one coming in, are there gonna be six this time? And so it's really quite fun. We had a close flyby. Our Parajove pass number 9 was Tuesday of this week, but the astronomers in this room probably know that Jupiter and the Sun are just right on top of each other in the sky right now. And what that means is that we cannot communicate with the spacecraft the way we ordinarily do. We had signals coming back from the low gain antenna that were detectable, so we know the spacecraft is okay. But we cannot send commands, we cannot get data when Jupiter is so close to the sun. So we will start getting the images from the perigeux pass number 9, the one that happened on Tuesday. We will start getting that data next week. It'll be played back then. Okay, I promised I would show some Jovian art. And I have to say, for me, this was one of the biggest surprises. I expected we'd get some enhanced color. I expected we'd get some whimsical creations and maybe a few collages and montages. I did not expect to see the great red spot as a stained glass window or as flower petals or the graphic view of Jupiter or the beautiful starry night. And it turns out that I think Van Gogh would have loved this planet. Certainly, everybody who loves Van Gogh likes to do things like this. So we're coming to an end here, and I am going to take questions when I'm done. The last thing I'm going to play for you is a movie that we put together as the spacecraft was approaching Jupiter. So it was last June and July, and we were just coming up on the planet, and so it was still quite distant in our field of view, which meant that we could image Jupiter and its moons. And so we could actually image that celestial event that was, you know, so profound for Galileo, got him kicked out of the Catholic Church for a while, caused the Pope to decide he needed an astronomer on his staff, and all sorts of other changes that came along with realizing that the Earth was not the center of the universe. So I'm going to play this movie, and it's a tribute, really, to Galileo, the astronomer. Off when they go behind Jupiter in its shadow.